Knock Knock is a strange game. It even claims that it's not a game on the splash screen. But I've played a game or two, so I think I know one when I see one. You play as a guy who lives deep in the forest. You have problems with insomnia or sleepwalking or some combination of the two. And every night you have to deal with the monsters of the forest as they invade your ever-changing house. You have to survive until morning and not let them drive you insane. It's important to fix your lights so you can remember what was in the rooms, and you can remember hiding places or these things that make time accelerate for a while. There's a story hidden behind everything, but like I said, this game is weird. All of the story is open for interpretation and obscured by your character's delirious sleep talk and nonsensical ramblings from your diary. The game doesn't even give you clear objectives, except that you need to survive until sunrise each night. It's particularly unclear during the sections where you walk around outside. It doesn't tell you what's important, so you have to decide that for yourself. But some things are more important than others, because when I got to the end of the game, I could only game over, no matter what I did. But looking up other people's playthroughs, there are other ways that the game can end. And since the game doesn't tell you what to do, it can be difficult to get a good ending without looking it up. One cool thing about this game is the messages you get between levels. They're like creepy games that feed off the power of suggestion, kind of like Bloody Mary. It's not really something that kids would actually do for a game, but it ties things together nicely. Sometimes the games relate to each other, and sometimes your character mentions similar things. It's a nice touch. My only real problem with the game is the gameplay is very repetitive. It's the same thing over and over again, every night, and it starts getting old around the time that there's this monster on the level map. Brain, door, thing. But you can see there aren't any levels after that, so it's fine. Psych! Two more levels! Then you beat those, and who ordered two more levels? I didn't. So this game is really cool and creative. The gameplay and pseudo-story are really interesting, but that doesn't last as long as the game does.